This is a transistor switching circuit. It's quite different from any vacuum tube switching circuit. The transistor itself acts as the switch. This kind of circuit is seldom used for such simple jobs as turning on lamps. It is used very frequently to perform mathematical operations in electronic computers. This film shows some elementary principles of transistor switching in computers. The basic characteristic of a switching circuit is the fact that it has only two possible operating conditions. Here, they are on and off. But any two-state circuit is called a switch, even though it may not be a simple on-off switch. This one has two different voltage outputs. And the other condition, the digit 1. Of the 10 digits, only 0 and 1 are actually used in computer design. Therefore, only simple two-state switches need be used. In the off condition, the output can represent either 0 or 1. The choice is arbitrary. In the on condition, the output, of course, will represent the other digit. This simple switch, used in various combinations, can perform mathematical operations. However, even elementary mathematical operations are too complex to be performed in one-stage electronic circuits. So the operations are broken down into steps. This circuit performs one such mathematical step. It is called an OR circuit because it delivers an output if either input A or input B is present. Here's another example. This is called an AND circuit because it delivers an output only when both input A and input B are present. The circuit consists of two switches in series. When both inputs are negative, current can flow in the load. If either input is positive, the corresponding emitter is reverse biased and the circuit through the load is interrupted. By using such combinations of switching circuits as this and this, complex computer systems can perform in seconds mathematical computations far too difficult to do at all with pencil and paper.